on a totally random note, all of the Michael Emerson that I've been watching today has really, really made me totally insane, and I've just had thoughts of jumping him all day. I'm not really sure why I'm telling you guys this, except the fact that I'm really, really tired, and every time I saw him on screen today, I just thought, dang, I would just attack that man. I would just jump on him and start ripping his clothes off, and we would be making, like, animals up against a wall. I don't know. It's really sort of become, like, a creepy thing, because I lay in bed now and I just fantasize and just like, oh my gosh, there are just so many ways and so many places. There's just not enough time in the world for me to sit here. There's, you know, there's on top a desk, up against a wall, across the floor, bed, classic, classic. You gotta hand it to the classics. There's... I don't know, he's driving me totally nuts today. I just feel this deep need to start writing some Michael Emerson fan fiction, or William Hinks fan fiction. His character from The Practice, oh yeah, he definitely needs some fan fiction of his own. Gosh, I can see it now, him coming in all smart aleck with that chick at the desk or whatever, and nobody else is there. The two of them are totally alone, and he's like, I'm looking for Lindsay, and she's all, she's not here right now, how can I help you? Yeah, you guys have no idea what I'm talking about, because half of my subscribers probably haven't even seen this episode of The Practice. I'm just gonna stop talking now. I'll just fantasize when the camera is off. How about that? Yes, I will do that. So, I watched the film Jumping Off Bridges, starring Michael Emerson and a bunch of unknown actors. And the best way that I can describe the film would be to say that it's like yogurt. Not very satisfying. Or like a slice of stale birthday cake that you just keep eating and waiting for it to get better, and then when you're done, you realize that it didn't taste very good. Honestly, there's more excitement in a bowl of cereal. You just wait for Michael Emerson to slowly execute these terrible actors one by one. He is the only redeeming quality about this crap film, and my guess is that he was totally broke and decided to prostitute himself on screen for this movie that I've retitled Blah Blah. Or he did it out of charity to be kind enough to these horrible producers who obviously had no idea what they were doing. I can just see them now begging on their knees, please, Michael, save this movie. You've read the script. You know that it's going to be crap unless we get a big draw into it. And of course, being the kind-hearted, good person that he is, Michael decided to lend his acting skills to this horrible team of whatever people that made this movie. And naturally, he was great. This role was a really, really nice change of pace for him. He plays such a soft and sweet character, and I just wanted to see more of him in this movie. Like, come on, Michael, get in there! Save it! Save it! It's crashing, and it's burning, and it's dying, and it's killing me. Unfortunately, I will never watch this film in its entirety again, because, frankly, Michael wasn't in it enough, and I will only watch his parts. And on a scale from 1 to 10, I would rather watch grass grow. And of course, I don't mean to ruin all the excitement for those who haven't seen it, because you guys out there might like boring movies like The Blair Witch Project, so that's all I have to say about this film for right now. And of course, I don't mean to ruin all the excitement for those who haven't seen it, because you guys out there might like boring movies like The Blair Witch Project, so that's all I have to say about this film for right now. I spent 3 days of my life downloading that movie. I knew that I should have just slept today. Anyway, in news that's way more exciting, I finally finished my Michael Emerson video that I had been dreaming about making for the past week. Now, I had originally made another one prior to the one that I'm going to show you, but I didn't really quite like the way I'd arranged the clips and decided to change the song. So the video that I am going to show you now, I think, is much better than the original, and I hope that you guys like it. Please tell me what you think, because I spent hours and hours redoing it so that I could get it just the way I imagined it in my head.
take my drink and I don't even want to. I think my thoughts when I don't even need to. I never look back cause I don't even want to. And I don't need to because I'm getting away with murder. I'm feeling rational, so confrontational. To tell the truth, I am getting away with murder. It is impossible to never tell the truth, but the reality is I'm getting away with murder.
Getting away, 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 getting away with murder.
So there you have it. That was the movie that I had been trying to make, and I didn't end up using any Sony Vegas special effects because I think the way that it turned out was really good without them. The original video pretty much consisted of the exact same clips with a different song, just arranged differently, so perhaps some of you hardcore Michael Emerson fans might want to see that. And if you do, please comment on the video you just saw and let me know if you want to see what the original looked like, and that's pretty much all that's going on with me today, so hope that everyone's having a lovely evening, and until next time, bye.